you always hear about the scientific process and the scientific method, but to actually say, what is your specific hypothesis? What do you think is going to happen? And then have the opportunity to work that process out, perform the experiment, and get actual data and results is really the coolest thing that I've ever done.
My part of the project is to measure the tissues in order to someday relate them to both the chemistry of the soybean plants and also to correlate that with the amount or the yield of biofuel that each of these soybean stems create.
Farmers in the state of Virginia can grow these locally and have a good renewable biodiesel crop that's good for the environment and also good for your car.
And Garrett has now all these skills that no matter, you know, he'll always take away with him this complex procedure, and knowing that he did something that was almost impossible and he learned it and mastered it. And Matthew's done a little bit different. He started out with the chemical techniques, and now he's learned image analysis software, so some skills that he never had. And you'll be getting into more complex data analysis as well.
In a classroom, it's like 1 on 15 or 1 on 12, and so you get spoken to, you don't get spoken with. Whenever you do research like this, it's really that one-on-one interaction with the professor and what it would feel like, I guess, in the real world and what you would be experiencing at your workplace.
It's been great, and it's just a growing collaboration. We started out with Major Tim Moore in the Civil Engineering Department, but we're also working with Colonel Seamers in the Applied Mathematics Department as well. And I feel like it's just a growing project that we're going to see continue to grow for years to come.